like Kerala, where I come from, we have rains often and good sunshine, so I feel at home. And my daughter moved in here a year ago. She's been worshipping here. Her name is Abigail, as mentioned. And she pulled in the other two children, Abner and Abilene. So we were very happy that we were here last week attending the service, listening to Pastor Gary and the message. Met Darius and a few other people, and we were also there in the group, men's group, which met, I mean, the other group that which we met, Max and all there. So we are happy with the men group meeting here. I'm excited because where two or three are gathered, God is there in their midst.
Amen.
So what makes this prayer or this group very special is the Creator is here. So we want every one of you to feel Him, hear Him, and experience Him. Because then only we'll go back different. If you touch an electric line and say, I don't want to be electrocuted, impossible. So if you say, I want to be in the presence of God and go back the same way, impossible. So you're going to be, each one of us are going to be blessed. This evening I'm planning to take three chapters very fast. That's from Genesis 1, 2, 3. All of you know the Bible begins with that. Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 says, in the beginning God created everything. So Bible doesn't give anybody a chance to argue or discuss. It says in the beginning God created everything. So belief and faith in God is by revelation and not by information. And it is the Father who attracts you to Him. So I'm glad that He has attracted so many men in this area to Him. And when God created everything, He created everything from nothing. So the beauty of the creation is that God can create something out of nothing. So if there is somebody struggling with nothing in life, something is going to happen. Because He creates everything from nothing. And everything you find in the creation, now some people believe that they believe in evolution, Charles Darwin. I'm a neurosurgeon basically, so I'm a scientist, you know that. So they believe that we were all created, you know, by evolution from monkey. And if there is anyone among the group who thinks that way, I have no objection, but my grandfather was never a monkey. And it's very clear that you can clone a monkey from a monkey and a donkey from a donkey, but you cannot clone a man from a monkey. Each one of us are so unique and so very special. And this evening, may God give you a wonderful revelation of who Heavenly Father is. And when He created everything from nothing, the world was dark and void. Dark and void. Sometimes our life can be dark and void. What made the creation happen? The Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. So if you want something to happen in our life, you and I must allow the Spirit of God to hover over us. To brood over us. The literal word, the original word is brood over us, like a mother hen sitting, waiting for the eggs to hatch. If there is somebody in this group who will say, okay, let the Holy Spirit brood over me, you are going to be a dynamite. When the Word and the Spirit meets, it's more powerful than atom bomb. Tamba is looking for someone like that. And I'm glad that this church has a fertile ground with Word flowing. And God is moving. He created everything from nothing. In the beginning, God created heaven and earth. So time, space, and matter came in the beginning. Time in the beginning. God created heaven and earth. As we move out of this world, and when Christ comes back, we are going to be an existence of timelessness, matterlessness, and spacelessness. I'm looking forward to that day, and it's going to happen very soon because all the prophecies of the second coming of Christ is almost through. Today, my subject is not that. My subject is from Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. So anybody who has a Bible or a mobile phone, we will quickly go over to that. Since it's a men's fellowship, I may focus a little too much on men. Don't get angry with me because that's way how it is. And this church, I'm so happy. We fight for the right for men, not for the right of men for men. So I'm glad that there is a men's fellowship here. And God really bless you all. So we read, anybody with John, Genesis chapter 1:26? Here God is saying, let us make man in our image, in our likeness. Each one of us are made in God's image and God's likeness. So when you brush your teeth tomorrow morning and see yourself in the mirror, say a hallelujah, praise the Lord. Because you and I are created in His image. Sometimes you may think the length of your nose is not much or something else is not good, but we are created in His image. That's the first message that I would like to share with you. And why? The very same verse. If you have taken that verse, you can read with me. That verse very clearly says,
and God said, let us make man in our image.
In our image.
After our likeness.
After our likeness.
And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea.
So why was man created? For dominion, for authority. We lost it by our own mistake. God wants us to get it back. God made man for dominion, for authority. Let us make man in our own image and likeness for dominion over the world. Now the world is now dominating us. We are so afraid of climate change. We are so afraid of what's going to happen tomorrow, how things are going. But let me tell you, God is in control and He never makes a mistake. So we are on the right place in the right time. And He made, how did He make them? He created them as male man. Female and male hidden in that. That's beautiful. If you read that in Genesis chapter 1, chapter 1 verse 27, He created man in His own image and created him male and female. Verse 27.
So God created man in His own image. In the image of God He created him. Male and female He created them.
Created them. That when He made Adam, He had female in him. Scientifically, let me explain. Man has got XY chromosome. Female has got XX chromosome. So when God created man, He created as a man with XY chromosome. Y chromosome is a weak chromosome. Don't get upset. And He created female with double X. Thank God it was double X and not triple X. You know, if you read Proverbs, it says, woman is like a storm. So never try to control a woman. Fly with her breeze. When she blows, when you know she's blowing hot and cold, just fly. Because if you're trying to control, your sail is going to be torn. It's double X in her. But thank God that only one X works at a time. Beautiful, no? How the creation is. He created man and woman together, male and female inside. And how did He create? Chapter 2, verse 7. How did He create them? He created them from the dust. Very simple Sunday school lesson. God created them from the dust. Why did He create man from the dust? Because He created angels from the pearls and diamonds and precious stones. And the angel became proud and became a devil. He thought, let's create man in dust so that he doesn't become proud. Oh my. You're worse than angel at times. We think we know everything, we can do everything. Thank God, because He has given us a high amount of testosterone, which compensates for the lack of that X, which gives us the aggressiveness, which gives us the anger push in life. That's God's creation. God has created beautifully with specific plan and specific idea. And He made us out of dust. And what did He do? He blew His breath. Can you read that verse? Chapter 2, verse 7.
Then the Lord God formed the man of dust from the ground and breathed into his nostril the breath.
Breathed into his nostril
the breath of life.
The breath of life.
And the man became a living
being. Man became a living being. All the other creation He created by a word. But man He created with His hands. He made the man with His hands. So we are very special. And He blew His life into us. So So we are even unique and very special, which is very different from dogs, animals, cows. I'm not trying to say that they are lower down, but it's very unusual to see two Alsatians worshipping or two cats saying, let's go to pray somewhere. They do understand the creation. They do understand the Creator. But the desire for God is there in us. The desire for eternity is put in us because that life breath was in us. Where did it all go wrong? How did things go wrong? Out of control. And he gave the first commandment to man, not to woman. So the law is always transferred to men. That's why I said today you're going to hear something different. He gave it to Moses. He spoke through prophets. So in the church, the role of a pastor is important. In a family, the role of the husband is important. Because God likes to speak to the man. He spoke to the man, and in that chapter, verse 9, he says, don't eat the tree of knowledge of good and evil, but tree of life you can eat. If you say don't eat, everybody wants to eat immediately. Like when Abner, and I have three children, Abner, Abigail, Abilene, when they were small, my wife will cook some food and say, eat, they won't eat. Big fuss. So she found out a secret. She'll put everything in front of me and say, this is for Papa. Within 10 minutes, they will eat. Say, don't eat. Forbidden fruit is so attractive. So he said, don't eat the tree of knowledge of good and evil. We think that God, for, you know, kept something away from us. Not true. Why did God say not to eat? Because God did not want us to know that there was evil. There was Satan. Satan wanted his entry. God wanted only us to know good things. Even today, through the media, through education, through everything, devil is promoting himself. And that's why we need to promote God. That's why we need to promote the Word of God. Because there is power in the Word of God. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm a neurosurgeon, so when I see the hands going up, I'm excited because people come to me when the hand is paralyzed. And I love hallelujah because in heaven there is no neurosurgery, only hallelujah. So I won't be jobless when I go there. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He created us so beautifully in his own image and gave us something very unique. God created a garden for this man to work. And then how did he go about? He found that it was very lonely for man. It has been studied medically and found that widows live long and widowers die fast. Men wanted company. God realized it. So what did he do? The first surgery he did in the Garden of Eden. First surgery. Paradise means fenced garden with restrictions. Christian life is always with restrictions. God gave only one commandment in the beginning. Then he gave 10 commandments to Moses. We can't even follow one. Imagine how will we follow 10. Very difficult. But God gives you the grace and strength and the Holy Spirit to do it. Amen?
Amen.
So he created woman. That's what my story today is. How did he create woman? He gave the first anesthesia, first surgery, and took a rib out. You know why he took the rib out? If he had taken a bone from the skull, she would sit on his head. If he had taken a bone from the feet, we will use her as a carpet. So he took it from the bosom, right here. So that she will be a helpmate for him. We are not looking for mates like animals look. A marriage is always a helpmate, a God-ordained person to build up a family, an institution of God. At this moment, let me tell you why a neurosurgeon is here and why is he excited to share the gospel, as I was introduced by Darius, that I came to know Christ when I was 5 years old. My father is a pastor, my mother is an evangelist. Back home in India, in Kerala, they are no more. I got filled with the Holy Spirit when I was 8 years old. And I started preaching the Word of God when I was 10 years old. I went to the street with this Bible, now just 10 years old. I have not stopped it even today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For me to live is Christ and to die is gain. That's what Paul says in Philippians. Because if I live for the car and the house and the building and my profession and my job, for my death will be the biggest disaster. But if I live for Jesus, eternity is beautiful. I want every one of us to have eternity more beautiful than the life in India, in America. So let me share my testimony. I don't know whether anyone has heard my testimony. I don't think there's anybody here who has heard my testimony, no. So let me share my testimony. I don't think I can complete it in 15, 20 minutes, and so I would request you to go to YouTube, type my name, GeorgeKovoor. I record all my messages and put it there so that people can see. Kovoor is K-O-V-O-O-R, and then you can get my YouTube channel, and please go into the English section because you will find a lot of Indian languages in that. So you may not like any of those or understand. So go to the English channel and start with the Word of Hope series. That's only 10 minutes each before you enter into the 1 hour, 2 hour messages. So start with the 10 minutes Word of Hope series in that. Now let me just give you an introduction. When I was born as a hydrocephalic baby. I don't know whether you know what it is. A huge head with water inside. Hydro means water, cephalus means head. And those days there was no surgery. My parents took me to the best center in India, Christian Medical College, Vellore. The first neurosurgeon of my country, Dr. Jacob Chandy, saw me. And he said, this child will not live. My professor, Dr. Jacob Abraham, saw me and said, even if you make this child live, he'll be physically, mentally retarded, good for nothing. People may look at you and criticize you, judge you, and say, you are good for nothing. Why are you alive? Even you yourself may say, what's the point of my life? But there is a God who is looking at you and saying, very good, because you are created in his own image. Bible says we are fearfully and wonderfully created. Bible says even before we are formed, he has seen us. He knows the end from the beginning. He knows the last day of our life. Every door was closed. 4 times they took water out. Now I operate such children. I put a tube in the brain and pump it to the stomach. It's a surgery called ventriculoperitoneal shunt surgery. Thank God that there was no surgery at that time. Doctor dependent, medicine dependent, shunt dependent, miserable life. Even yesterday's prayer meeting, I met a grandmother who told me, please pray for my grandchild after the shunt. He is in Texas. He's had a meningitis and he's mentally retarded. Please pray for him. She showed me the photographs. Thank God that there was no surgery at that time. Everything was closed. My parents came back home, but they knew Psalm 121, which says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From where does my help come? My help comes from the God who created heaven and earth. Tonight, God, you are going to see a miracle. You are going to see a help coming in your life. If there is any blockage in your life, whether it be financial, whether it be in your job situation, whether it be in your family life, it doesn't matter. My Jesus is a Savior. He is able to take you through till the end because he is the author and perfecter of your faith. Allow him to write your story and your story will become his story. When all the doors closed, they started praying. And God spoke to them. You know what God said? Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and everything shall be added unto you. They left the vomiting child with the grandmother and went out to preach the word of God. Kingdom of God came down for me. Why am I standing here in the New Walk Church speaking to the men's group? Because Jesus healed me. And when Jesus heals you, he doesn't leave you halfway through. He makes you a neurosurgeon who is taking care of such children. God wants to do something beyond your imagination, which you can never think. You're so satisfied, so content, you think everything is over. No, he has just begun. In 2019, he has something very special. Amen. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God created man, and then he created a helpmate. And you know what? When Adam saw this man in verse 24, chapter 1, verse 24, it says, he will cleave from his father and he will leave his father and mother and will cleave to him, and they will become one flesh. That is marriage. Marriage is for procreation, not for recreation. I would say sex. So it's basically for God-ordained thing. And chapter 1, verse 28, it says, be fruitful and multiply. Be fruitful and multiply. So first thing is dominion. Second thing is fruitfulness. third is multiplication. These are the three messages. God is going to give you back the authority you have lost on your own self, self-discipline, control your own self and emotions, controlling situation around. God will bless you. Like this time, we left home in March. I went to Australia and New Zealand as a missionary. I'm just coming back from there. So when I was leaving the country, my wife said, it's so hot in Kerala. Why do you want to go to Sydney, Brisbane and all? It's even hotter now. I said, so what? Let's go. God has given us an opportunity to share. I will pray that you will get rains when we land. Will you believe with me? When our flight was landing in Sydney, the pilot says, we are expecting showers.
Wow.
Believe with me, we are climate changers. We shake the world. We move the Holy Spirit. Believe with me, the authority God has given is nothing simple. When Jesus left, he said, all authority on heaven and earth I am giving you. When will you experience it? When you start sharing the gospel.
Amen.
Only for people who are willing to share the gospel and stand for the kingdom, the authority will start flowing. You will start seeing a change in your life because the Spirit of God is a spirit of power, love, and sound mind. So the dominion, authority, and fruitfulness multiply. That's what God wants us to have. And then what happened? Seventh day, God rested. God wants us to rest. Rest is very important. Sleep is very important. Now there is a big study called sleep study. Sleep is like anesthesia. The night, the brain, you can't repair a running car. So God offs us completely. Only the autonomic system is awake. The rest is completely off. So if your sleep is bad, your life is bad. Only God can give you sleep. CPAP may help some sleep apnea, but good sleep is only from heaven. So if you have any problem, you need to get that sleep from heaven. God will give you the rest. And then chapter 2, he gave law to man. But what went wrong? In chapter 3, devil wanted to deceive this lady. There was a communication gap between the man and the woman. Even now, then, communication between woman and man is very difficult. So let me take a few minutes on that. Interesting?
Yeah.
Good. Because our brains are made similar, but functions differently. To understand the woman, you really need the grace of God.
Amen.
They don't think like this.
Oh.
So don't tell them, please understand me. They will never understand. And we cannot expect, because we are created the same brain, but differently. Now let me tell you a few differences for your knowledge, just for knowledge. It's not part of my message. Men have a peripheral vision which is tubular like this. We see like this because we were created as hunters, long distance like this. Women have peripheral vision like this because they were keeping the home. So if anybody comes like that. So that's why boys, when they look at girls, they stare like this. Women can look at the book and see the boy's shoes and face, everything. Their eyes are like this. You think they are reading the book? No, they are looking at you. Very easy for them to stare at you. Secondly, their powerful nose, their eyes, their colors are different. We have only a few colors. They have more shades. Our brain corpus callosum is smaller. Women have a thick corpus callosum. That means there's a lot of interconnections. It's all wired like this. Men have small boxes. So when we come tired and watching the TV, the lady comes and says something, we'll say, ha, 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 nothing is going. We are right in the football game. It's just to get, she doesn't realize that all that R doesn't mean anything. There is a time, there is a way that the woman has to approach and speak for him to get it in. It's very different. So that's why there is a book, I don't know whether you read, Men Are From Mars and Women Are From Venus. I don't know, it's a beautiful book, it's nothing biblical. And also, we find women very difficult to reverse. Drive, men find it easier because our brains are wired for driving. Women find it very difficult. But let me tell you, if you can take your wife into confidence, and if you can work like a team, their support in your life is wonderful. They understand people quickly. They are more logical. They'll come into conclusions faster. But only thing is that God wants you to be the one leading them. You to be the one praying with them. You to be the one main leadership from man. If we fall back, the church is falling back. That's why this church is giving focus on men. When men fall back, everything goes away. I was preaching in St. Louis in a church on Father's Day. I said, God is the person who is maximally misunderstood and even father. It's so sad that we are coming into a fatherless community. There's an epidemic in America which is called fatherlessness. The lady himself is not able to point out who is the father to the child. That's a saddest situation. I hope things will change, that men will take the leadership, that lady will stay together with him and form this beautiful home that God is wanting them to do. Maybe in the discussion we'll have a little more about the brain, but let me quickly come towards the end. When God realized, when man did the mistake, when the devil came and told him, the lady had it, and he also agreed, had the tree of knowledge. Even now, we want only knowledge. That's why Google is thriving. We don't want to live. Church is not a place for information. Church is a place for revelation. Tonight, we have not come here for information. We have come for revelation. God gives you revelation. The Word of God gives you revelation. Understanding into life. Not knowledge and information. That's going to spoil you. Too much of information. This is an age of information. But what we need is the Holy Spirit, which gives you the wisdom to do the right thing at the right time. So when man made the mistake, instead of going to God, he realized his eyes were opened. He realized he was naked. And he went hiding. Many times we do that. We hide away from God. Men are from Mars, means they live in cave. They like to hide all the time. And the women will come poking, speak, see. Hiding. Say, why are you not speaking? Hiding. Because we like to hide, we like to remain silent. Man went away and he was hiding. God came down for man, searching for him, saying, Adam, where are you? Tonight, Jesus is here. He's searching for you. Coming to church is good. Churchianity is good, but that's not enough. Listening to the word of God is good, but that's not enough. You and I need to have a personal encounter with Jesus. And we need to be falling in love with him. And kingdom should be the first priority in our life. Jesus should be the first priority. The kingdom of God should be the first priority. Once that happens, the whole life changes. So the last bit, they went and hid. And what did they do? They made a cloth out of leaves. Oh, I don't know whether it's like our latest jeans or Wranglers or whatever that you want to call. Some nice one. And they thought that was fine. By evening, it was all shaky. Your righteousness, which you cover yourself, becomes shaky after some time. Your good works cannot please God. By evening, they couldn't come out because the sun had finished off all their clothing. God gave them a cloth of skin. He killed a lamb. The lamb that was slain before the foundation for the salvation of man. When angels disobeyed, he prepared hellfire. But when man disobeyed, he made a salvation program. That is what I want to tell you. If you disobey, if I disobey, if we fall short, don't run away from him. Don't hide from him. Come to him. Come in prayer. He will take you. He will give you up heaven. He will change your situation. He will forgive the sins, however bad it is. And he will help you out. He made a garment and gave it to them. And that's how he showed them that I have an escape route for you. Jesus came 2,000 years ago to save the mankind. Still, many people in this country and in my country don't even know who is God. And it's our responsibility, yours and mine, to take the word of God to others. In my life, I have always been telling my testimony. I'll close with one more testimony. You know, I love saying testimony. Any of you like to say testimony, make sure that you say in the next 1 week to whoever you meet, I finished my MS general surgery from Christian Medical College, Ludhiana, and I was going looking for doing neurosurgery. The first premier institution is All India Institute in Delhi. And I was working with the Sehgal Nursing Home, a nurse, a neurosurgeon in Delhi. And I wanted to get in there. And Psalm 37 says, delight in the Lord and he'll give you the desires of your heart. And I said, Lord, give me an opening there. And I believed that God is going to give me an opening. I made a biodata, fixed up an appointment with Dr. Banerjee, who is the professor and head of the department. Went to him and said, sir, I want to work with you. He said, what? I said, I want to work in your department. I love to do neurosurgery. He said, you can't just come into this institution and say, I want a job. This is the number one institution. You have to pass the examination. You have to be either sponsored by the military or by the government. We have only a few seats and there's no time for it. I said, sir, you know I've got number one mark. You see my grade. I finished from a good institution and I'm excited about it and I heard about you, all kinds of things. He said, no, he's about to kick me out. I said, let me leave my biodata with the secretary. He said, okay. When I went out and came back, my friends asked what happened. I said, he asked me to leave the application with the secretary. That's faith, seeing beyond what is happening. Within 5 days, I get a call from Dr. Banerjee saying, can you come over? I was so excited. I took half day and went. I asked, sir, did you call me? He said, yes. Do you want to join? I said, yes. Can you do it today? I said, yes. So happy that within 5 days God made me get a job there. Immediately I went and filled all the forms and got the job. It's a very good job, central government job, high paying job. So I had to get about 20 signatures from different people. I was going to the canteen, I'm going to sit there and eat. Anybody who comes in the front, I'm going to testify. I'm ready for my testimony. One man came and sat there. I said, hi, how are you? I'm GeorgeKovoor. You know, I got into neurosurgery today. He said, I'm Dr. So-and-so. I resigned from neurosurgery yesterday. I got the job in his position. I said, thank you very much. Whatever you want to eat, it's on my name. We sat together and talked for a long time. God gave him a job in England to give me a job in that institution. My God is a great God. And as he left, he gave me an application for Christian Medical College, Ludhiana, which was already, well off, which was the last day, was only 3 days from then. I got my neurosurgery training with that application. My Heavenly Father is alive. He is able to take you every day of your life. You don't need to worry about your life. You don't need to plan about your life because your life is in his hand and you will never fail because he will never fail you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. I will be with you till the end of your ages. Thank you all and God bless you.
Amen. Amen.